back to my YouTube channel, Show here again, and today we're going to be doing yet another wig review, and this wig review is brought to you by Wig Types. But before we get started, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, and if you're new to my channel, welcome. So today we're going to be reviewing this wig that was sent to me by Wig Types, where you guys can buy all different types of affordable wigs. They also have hair products, they have hair pieces and all of that, so make sure that you guys definitely check them out, and their shipping is on point. So yes, just go ahead and check them out. But today's wig is from Bobby Boss, and the last wig review that I did for Wig Types, it was also a faux locks wig. So I was really excited to review this one. I did mention that I was going to review this one, and so here I am, you guys. And I am so here for this setting behind me. It's such a vibe. I wish I can film at this time for you guys, because I just love the way that the room looks at nighttime, but I can't always do that. But I'm gonna try to bring more videos like this, because I'm so in love right now. Like, I need to film more videos like this. But anyways, let's get into this review. So today's wig is from the Natural Style Wig Collection. And this one, it has a very long name, like the collection itself. So it's from the Natural Style Wig Boss Lace First Class Hair Collection. And the style of this wig, the name is MLF 614 California Locks. That's probably like what it, the whole name of it, but it says Calif Locks 16. So I'm going to guess the 16, it means it's 16 inches of hair. I am wearing it in the color 1B. She does come in different colors if you're interested. I would honestly, like after trying this one, I would honestly want to try maybe the T 1B/30, or like anything with blonde in it, just because I'm officially kind of like a blonde. I'm transitioning into a blonde with my natural hair, so I would want to try that. But I did want to try more of a natural color because I was just scared of how the wig was going to sit. This wig has a 4x4 deep lace parting space, so as you guys got to see, I was able to part it different ways, and it does come parted in the middle when you first get it, which boom, that's what it looks like when it's parted in the middle. I honestly really did like the swoop to the side. I'm gonna just keep it in the middle for the remainder of the video, but I preferred it swoop to the side. And I did add some little metal clippings, like the little gold clips to it, just to add a little something to it, just a little fun, you know. And it does also have baby hairs, but just like the other wig, the baby hairs were a little bit more difficult. These were a little softer, I'm not gonna lie to you, so these were a little bit more manageable, but they quickly did like frizz up and stuff, so I just left it alone. And I did actually remove this wig earlier after I filmed, and then I put it back on, and I didn't even glue it back on, so it's not glued on right now, but it looks fine on camera. It looks fine, so I'm fine with what it looks like right now. Like, I'm not even tripping. But it does come with that extra lace in the front where you guys can customize it. You can go ahead and play around with the hairline if you want to, put your powder on there and all of that. So let's get into what I think about the wig. So the wig itself, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I preferred the other wig better, although it was just a middle part, just because it did sit a little bit flatter. And the crazy part is that my foundation underneath the wig is a lot flatter than last time. So this one is kind of sitting a little bumpy, in my opinion. That's just me. Maybe I would just have to wrap it, like I told you guys in the last video, to go ahead and wrap the wig itself at the top so that it sits a lot more flat. But I just feel like it sits a little bit bumpy. I do love that it's pretty full. Also, another thing with this wig, I don't know if you guys noticed in the video, but it does come stitched up. So some of the locks, you may want to kind of like cut the stitching off so that you're able to get more movement, more body movement. I feel like the stitching is just more for structure so that it does look a little bit more neat, or maybe because of wefts showing. But with this wig, with the fullness of it, I don't believe any wefts are showing. I just show you guys the perimeter of the wig and all of that, the sides, the back, all of it. But I do not believe that any wefts show on this wig, so you don't have to worry about that. But I believe that Bobby Boss did that purposely, so just in case if there was any wefts showing, that wouldn't be an issue. This is kind of giving a little almost butterfly locks in a way, because it does have like kind of like lock, like the locks do have kind of like a pop out motion, not a motion, but like a pop out type of look to it. And I love that about it. It does make it look a little bit more natural. I did try kind of like the little bun type of hairstyle, like where you could just put the bun up like this. Let me see. And you're able to do that as well, like very, very easily and all of that. The only thing is that you may not be able to do a half up, half down with this wig. And that, I mean, I guess that's totally fine because I wouldn't experiment that much with it. But you probably won't be able to do that with it because of the size of the wig itself. I don't feel like the way it sits, because it has so much hair, it's going to like sit very, very flat. But as you guys can see, you could kind of play around with the style. And yeah, I just feel like it's a cute wig. I just feel like maybe the way it would sit, it should be less bumpy. I also feel like just the hairline right here in the front, they should have made it look a little bit more natural if they were going for a 4x4. But other than that, I think that the wig is actually kind of cute. It makes me want to try other lock wigs just to see, just to experiment, because I do like to challenge myself. I do get a lot of compliments from you guys where you guys say that I do try wigs that people normally wouldn't really play around with. And I just really love to challenge myself. Like, I really like to try different styles. And on top of that, if I don't have to sit in the salon for whatever hours it takes to do this, like 6-7 hours, that is definitely a plus. And I mentioned that in my last video. I think that that is definitely a plus if I don't have to sit 6 or 7 hours to get this style. I actually walked out my house today with this wig on, and that's how you know that I actually liked it, because I normally would not walk out with any braided wigs or lock wigs unless they look like very, very natural, or like I have a head wrap covering it. But I actually enjoy this wig. I think it's actually very, very cute. I love the style. I love the fact that it's a little shorter, so it's not as heavy. It's not a lot of hair. And yeah, that's about it. That's all I have for you guys. So let me know what you think in the comments below if you've tried this wig. Shout outs to Bobby Boss for creating this beauty. And also shout outs to Wig Tex for sending me this wig to review for you guys. Make sure that you definitely check them out on their website and also their Instagram. I will be putting their website below and the link to purchase this wig. I will also be putting my Instagram so you guys can keep up with me. I'm always active on Instagram, so make sure you follow me at Pratanos Best. And if you haven't done so, sis, I had to swallow because I was about to die saying all of that. If you haven't done so, go ahead and subscribe. Subscribe to my channel and like this video. And if you like this video, if you enjoyed it, I will see you guys soon. Bye. I can't believe I'm next to you.